that Prince Charles is now King Charles III. There had been some speculation over what regnal name he would choose, because monarchs actually do get to choose their name, but it was revealed during the Prime Minister's speech on the day that the Queen died that he had chosen Charles III. The other possibility had been George VII, being that most British kings since 1714 have gone by George. For example, the Queen's father had actually been called Albert, but when he became king, he was known as George VI, even though he had a younger brother named George. Camilla is now Queen Consort. It had previously been thought that she would use the title Princess Consort. However, during Queen Elizabeth's Platinum Jubilee, the Queen announced that Camilla would use the term Queen Consort. Now, keep in mind that there is a difference between the type of queen that Queen Elizabeth was and the type of queen that Camilla is. Queen Elizabeth was a queen regnant, meaning that she was the reigning monarch, not her husband. However, Camilla is a queen consort, meaning that she's the wife of the monarch. The last time that the UK had a queen consort was in 1952, when Queen Elizabeth's mother, also called Elizabeth, held that role. She was not, however, Elizabeth I. Queen consorts don't get numbers. Queen Elizabeth I was the famous queen that reigned during Shakespeare's time. Now, as soon as the queen passed, Charles's firstborn son William became both the Duke of Cornwall in England and the Duke of Rothesay in Scotland, because those titles are automatically given to any male who is first in line to the throne. Now, he already held the title Duke of Cambridge, so he is now a duke three times over. In England, he's the Duke of Cornwall and Cambridge. Cornwall comes first because it's the higher title, and his wife is the Duchess of Cornwall and Cambridge. Their Rothesay titles are only used when they are in Scotland. However, the day after the Queen's death, King Charles bestowed upon William the additional title of Prince of Wales. Now, this is something that did not happen automatically. The king had to actually bestow it. Traditionally, ever since the year 1301, the title has almost always been bestowed upon the heir apparent to the English or later the British throne. Prior to this, the title had been used by actual Welsh monarchs who ruled the Principality of Wales, which was an independent monarchy that existed from 1216 to 1283. However, in 1283, Wales became part of the Kingdom of England, and hence the title is now used as more of a ceremonial one, rather than being an actual title that indicates who's in charge of Wales. Now, because William is the new Prince of Wales, this means that his wife, Catherine, is the new Princess of Wales, the title Princess of Wales being simply a courtesy title. The last person to use it was, of course, William's mother, Diana. Technically, Camilla had the right to use it as well, but she chose not to, and prior to becoming Queen Consort, she was known as the Duchess of Cornwall. Previously, William and Kate's three children used the phrase of Cambridge after their names. However, they will now use the phrase of Wales. Their places in the line of succession have also gone up, with William's son George, in particular, now being second in line to the throne instead of third. Now, some people have asked why Harry is not second. Well, the reason is because European titles are usually passed down, not across, a system known as primogeniture. Keep in mind that if primogeniture was not used, this would mean that Andrew would be first in line, followed by Edward, rather than William, followed by George. And speaking of Harry, he does move up from 6 to 5 in the line of succession, but he and Meghan did not receive any new titles. In case you are thinking that the second-born son always receives the title Duke of York, no, this is not the case. Traditionally, a second-born son does often receive this title, but only if it is not already held by someone else. And currently, the title is held by the king's brother, Andrew. So basically, it's unavailable. However, there is one big change that has occurred with regard to Harry and Meghan's family. Their children, Archie and Lilibet, are now officially a prince and princess. In order to be a British prince or princess, one has to be either a child of a monarch, a grandchild in a male line, or a child of the heir's eldest son. Previously, William and Kate's children met the requirement, but Harry and Meghan's did not. However, now that they are the grandchildren of the king in a male line, they are automatically prince and princess. Now, whether or not their parents will actually choose to let them use those titles is yet to be seen. In a similar scenario, Prince Edward's two children were automatically born prince and princess, but their parents chose to have them use lesser titles instead. So those are the main changes, but let me point out a few more things. Obviously, everyone else moves up one place in the line as well, but I won't go through everyone because I actually did that in a previous video earlier this year. I'll link to that in the description if you want to learn more about some of the quote-unquote lesser royals. However, I will remind everyone that both Harry and Andrew are still in the line of succession, even though in both cases they are not official working members of the royal family, albeit for very different reasons. Basically, the only thing that can remove you from the line of succession is death, or actually becoming the monarch and then quickly abdicating. One more title that is likely to change soon is that of the king's youngest brother, Edward. He is currently known as the Earl of Wessex. However, it has long been known that he will eventually be named the Duke of Edinburgh. This title was previously held by the king's father, Prince Philip, but it automatically passed to Charles when Philip died. However, now that Charles is king, the title has basically gone extinct, because a king cannot officially hold any lesser titles. This now means that he can bestow it anew on whoever he chooses, and it's almost certain that he'll bestow it on Edward. From there, it will presumably pass to his son James, and then on to James's son, if he has one. The king's only sister is currently known as the Princess Royal, a title traditionally given to a monarch's eldest daughter. But again, a person can only receive the title if it is available. For example, Queen Elizabeth was never Princess Royal, even though she was the eldest daughter of a king. This is because during the entire time that George VI was king, the title was held by his sister Mary. If Princess Anne were to die anytime soon, the title would become vacant because Charles does not have any daughters. However, if Anne dies when William is king, then presumably the title will be bestowed upon William's daughter, Charlotte. I should also point out that it's possible that Louis may someday be given the title Duke of York, as this title has traditionally been given to second-born sons. And unless the king decides to strip Andrew of his title and give it to Harry, the next person who's likely to get it will probably be Louis, sometime after William is king. Okay, so that was a look at some of the changes that have occurred since the passing of Britain's longest reigning monarch of all time. Thanks for watching.